Oh, shit. You don't know about doing whatever the fuck you want? Damn. I'm sorry, man. Hope you find that someday.
Hey, today we're going to talk about Clarence Thomas and, as always, Mexico. So one of the more surprising Supreme Court justices has come out in favor of legalization, kind of. Clarence Thomas is arguably the most conservative on the bench right now. He's infamous from the nomination hearings back in the 90s with Anita Hill, and ever since he's kind of had this very kind of curmudgeon-esque attitude towards most things and has always kind of come out on the side of the conservative. However, an appeal went to the Supreme Court, which is a Colorado dispensary trying to get federal tax breaks. They dismissed it. However, in his dismissal, Clarence Thomas talks specifically about the strange paradox and whole strange situation of federal view of marijuana. I'm just going to read some quotes because I think that's probably the best way. So he said, "A prohibition on interstate use or cultivation of marijuana may no longer be necessary or proper to support the federal government's piecemeal approach. Federal policies of the past 16 years have greatly undermined its reasoning. The federal government's current approach is a half-in, half-out regime that simultaneously tolerates and forbids local use of marijuana." Great. I mean, that's kind of what we all know to be true, but to hear someone like him, Clarence Thomas, who is looked up to on a lot of the right, and to hear him actually say this could go a long way in getting some Republicans to really kind of reconsider. And anything, any little bit counts. And that's why all of these Republican heads of their party saying anything about marijuana, that's why that is news, because it goes a long way in changing the paradigm and changing the perspective that most people on the right have with it. And once that happens, then Biden will see it as a bipartisan opportunity, which he's all about. So that is kind of what we're looking for. And this is going to be one big step towards that direction. And as we talked about last week, and in a funny contrast to what we have as the Supreme Court here in the US, Mexico's Supreme Court has voted in favor of getting rid of the prohibition of marijuana, meaning 8 of the Supreme Court justices have voted in favor, and basically marijuana is now legal in Mexico. And this kind of puts them in a very strange position because there are no regulations, there's no bill in place, so it's just kind of this free-for-all at this moment, and there's a lot of pressure on the legislation to change this or to create something that kind of gives it a shape. So hopefully this will put a lot of pressure on them. There's no real news in this. It's just now kind of like seeing what happens, like what is going to happen when you just kind of blanket legalize marijuana without doing anything else. So in one of the more unexpected ways, Mexico has legalized marijuana, and that's official. That has officially happened. And finally, one smaller story, Delaware was getting very close to legalization. However, of course, they got nabbed at the social equity part of the bill, and it wasn't able, even though it was supposed to come up into session today, it wasn't able to because they wouldn't have the votes. They basically wouldn't have the votes because of the social equity. And it's frustrating because that is such a huge part of marijuana legalization. It's one of the bigger reasons to legalize marijuana. But when that is a part of these smaller state bills, that's where all the kinks come in. So they will not be legalizing this year because of this social equity part of the bill. But the person who sponsored the bill says that they're just going to have a better bill because of it. And that's all the story that we have today. We'll be back on Wednesday with some more. See you then.
I just don't understand. Like, I never get on you for having your things. Like, this is my thing. Why are you getting on my back for this?
Bro, it's not a thing.
It is.
It's not a thing.
It's a thing.
It's a gallon of milk every time I see you.